Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Dearly beloved, we have come together in the presence of God to witness and bless the joining together of this man and this woman in holy matrimony. The bond and covenant of marriage was established by God in creation. And our Lord Jesus Christ adorned this manner of life by his presence and first miracle at a wedding in Cana of Galilee. It signifies to us the mystery of the union between Christ and his church. And Holy Scripture commends it to be honored among all people. The union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given one another in prosperity and adversity, and when it is God's will, for the procreation of children and their nurture in the knowledge and love of the Lord. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God. Into this holy union, Jordan Mariah Stallings and Daniel Levi Knight now come to be joined. If any of you can show just cause why they may not lawfully be married, speak now, or else forever hold your peace. I require and charge you both here in the presence of God that if either of you know any reason why you may not be united in marriage lawfully and in accordance with God's word, you do now confess it. Jordan, will you have this man to be your husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Daniel, will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? Now, this next question is to all of you, and I know you want to respond from the fullness of your heart. We want the angels in heaven to know what we're up to today. So the response is we will, and I hope that you will give it your best shout out. Will all of you, witnessing these promises, do all in your power to uphold these two persons in their marriage?
We will.
Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O gracious and ever-living God, you have created us male and female in your image. Look mercifully upon this man and this woman who come to you seeking your blessing, and assist them with your grace, that with true fidelity and steadfast love, they may honor and keep the promises and vows they make. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. Not too long.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have faith, all faith, so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind, love is not envious, or boastful, or arrogant, or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. But as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now I see in a mirror dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now, faith, hope, and love abide. These three, and the greatest of these is love. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from Paul's letter to the Colossians. As God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other. Just as the Lord has forgiven you, you also must forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in the one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and with gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John. Glory to you, Lord Christ. Jesus said, "As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ. Please be seated. This is the part that I promised I'd keep short. So here it is. Here it is. Did you hear what Jesus said? How are we, you didn't hear a word of it. How are we to love each other? How are you to love each other? You're to love each other as Christ loves us. That's a tall order. Because there's going to be more days, thankfully, that are like this one, where, you know, love's just kind of all flinging around. And where, hello, look like a bee. But there's going to be other days, too, of course, where it's a little harder. And you'll have to remember that the way that you're setting out to love one another is with the love that forgives and forgives and forgives, that trusts and trusts and trusts, with the love that is more than you have for yourself, you have for each other. That becomes the defining purpose. Just as God is love, so your life together is meant to be love in that same way. Those that know me out here and on TV land or whatever, no doggone well, I could stay on that subject for a half an hour, but I'm not going to because the governor says I should. Let us love as Christ loved us. Thank you.
In the name of God.
I, Daniel.
Take you, Jordan.
Be my wife.
Be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
This day forward.
From this day forward.
The better, the worse.
The better, the worse.
The richer, the poorer.
The richer, the poorer.
The sickness and the health.
Sickness and health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Now that Jordan and Daniel have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, with the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings, I pronounce that they are husband and wife, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Amen.
Amen.
Please stand. Now let us pray together in the words our Savior has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us
this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, Eternal God, creator and preserver of all life, author of salvation and giver of all grace, look with favor upon the world you have made and for which your Son gave his life, and especially upon this man and this woman whom you make one flesh in holy matrimony. Give them wisdom and devotion in the ordering of their common life, that each may be to the other a strength in need, a counselor in perplexity, a comfort in sorrow, and a companion in joy. Grant that their wills may be so knit together in your will, and their spirits in your spirit, that they may grow in love and peace with you and with one another all the days of their life. Give them grace when they hurt each other, to recognize and acknowledge their fault, and to seek each other's forgiveness and yours. Make their life together a sign of Christ's love to this sinful and broken world, that unity may overcome estrangement, forgiveness heal guilt, and joy conquer despair. Bestow on them, if it is your will, the gift and heritage of children, and the grace to bring them up to know you, to love you, and to serve you. Give them such fulfillment of their mutual affection that they may reach out in love and concern for others. Grant that all married persons who have witnessed these vows may find their lives strengthened and their loyalties confirmed. Grant that the bonds of our common humanity, by which all your children are united one to another and the living to the dead, may be so transformed by your grace that your will may be done on earth as it is in heaven, where, O Father, with your Son and the Holy Spirit, you live and reign in perfect unity, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Most gracious God, we give you thanks for your tender love in sending Jesus Christ to come among us, and to be born of a human mother, and to make the way of the cross to be the way of life. We thank you also for consecrating the union of man and woman in his name. By the power of your Holy Spirit, pour out the abundance of your blessing upon this man and this woman. Defend them from every enemy. Lead them into all peace. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts, a mantle about their shoulders, and a crown upon their foreheads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, in their sleeping and in their waking, in their joys and in their sorrows, in their life and in their death. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that table where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully with his favor look upon you and be gracious to you. Fill you with all spiritual benediction and grace, that you may faithfully live together in this life, and in the age to come, have life everlasting. Okay, on a Sunday morning, we greet each other. This time, the only greeting that's going on is between the two of you. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you.
Some time, but wasn't that beautiful? I'll ask you to go ahead and leave through the back door here where you came in and head on over to the Tropicana. There, the family needs to stay put because there's a few more pictures to be taken, but everybody else is supposed to go ahead on. Daniel and Jordan said that they will see you over there when the party really gets started. Peace of the Lord be always with you. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.